Hi, my name's Gordon. I'm a 28-year-old architect living in Fitzroy, Melbourne. And can you take your bike on the show? If you're not crashing off it enough, you're not going hard enough.
He rides his bike too much.
He's not shy, mate.
And with that hair, you can always find him in a party.
He's very blunt.
Well, his track record with roommates isn't too flash.
He's got a different haircut every week.
He's got a big head anyway.
He doesn't do compassion.
And I like to go sick, get off my head, and have lots of fun.
Interview with Gordon, take 37. Get it right, mate.
Nightlife regime on a big night would probably be sort of heading out Friday and coming home Tuesday. I guess just pushing the limits to see where the end is. I reckon it'll be like from different ends of the spectrum, from fun to hell. I normally get on with most people, you see, but I'm sure they'll throw a few people in there that you bound to not get on with very well. Yeah, just looking forward to having a bit of fun, actually.
Response you normally get when you leave the house?
Nah, a bit bigger actually.
Really? Do you need a minute to settle down? There are chocolates there if you want to have a nibble.
No, only Toblerone, so that's fine.
All right. Oh, that's a good plug. We know who you'll be sponsoring next. Now tell me, are you in shock? Are you okay?
No, I'm fine. Three out of four times, I've been gearing up to leave, so last time was just so surprising I didn't, so it took a bit of getting over the fact that I wasn't sitting here last week, so.
Did this mean that you could never settle into the house because you always felt that everyone wanted you out?
I reckon it was kind of cool because, like, every week could be your last. So I was like, is there anything I haven't done? You know, everyone else is just, like, clocking off time and stuff, and I'm just going, all right, let's get it on, you know, like, last week here and stuff, so it was good.
But that frustrated you, didn't it, that you didn't have people to get it on with?
Yes.
What happened?
Well, mostly because my friend Jason over there is pretty crazy, so... Yeah, a day inside the house is pretty chilled and a day outside the house is pretty crazy. So, it took some getting used to.
Now, can you talk to us about the hair? Because while you've been inside the house, your hair has been an issue.
I know. I love that. Yeah, I'm into having a non-symmetrical hairstyle and stuff. And
why?
Because I reckon I got about 9 months of hair left, so I might as well utilise the most of it.
Right. Okay, so is it to stand out? Is it to be an individual? Is it to keep you upright? What is it?
Cheaper than buying new clothes and, I don't know, yeah, I just like it, just messing around and having fun. Yeah.
And we've had a lot of people coming here looking exactly like you.
Yeah.
Not as buffed as you, I know. Did that become a bit of an outlet for you?
It was good just to, like, you know, having a training camp every morning, I guess, so it was kind of cool.
And now one of the outlets, which I actually think would have become a little bit frustrating, was Gemma. What happened there?
No, nothing.
Did you fall in love with Gemma?
Oh, no, I think she's a lovely girl. Yeah, I didn't fall in love with her or anything. No, I just think she's a genuinely beautiful person, yeah.
And what did you think about all the other girls in the house?
I think it was a great team of people.
Come on, you can speak honestly now. There are no cameras on you.
No, I would have had it a little bit more amped up and stuff, and I was disappointed, obviously, when Todd left and Andy left, because they were, like, extreme people that I really responded well to. So for me, it was kind of, like, a shame when they left. It was like, oh, you know, all the fun was sort of draining out of the house, so it was probably about time I left as well.
All right, well, I just before we go to break, let me just see, would you like to know what the tallies actually were?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Okay. Well, have a look at that. Can you see the screen?
Ah, interesting.
There are only a few thousand votes in it.
That's
amazing,
cool.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Would you actually like... Well, this isn't even a question.
Yeah.
Because we're going to see who nominated you. Can you deal with that?
Oh,
you
yeah,
can hold
yeah.
on to me as tight no, as you fine. Want during that's this fine. Experience.
I thought you were going to say much worse things. Don't worry.
No, let's
that's
have
fine.
A look.
Shoot, what we got?
The first person I'm going to nominate, Gordon. Sometimes it says a lot of things that offend the group generally.
Second one this week will be Gordon. Gordy wants to go, pretty much.
Gordon, two votes.
She's done compromising.
Gordon, I'm giving him 1 point because there are just certain things about Gordon that kind of just bug me.
My first person is Gordon. He, I think, thinks quite highly of me. He makes me feel a little bit uncomfortable at times. And I think I've said the same reason I've given before. I think over time that could get worse.
Now, I actually have a beautiful message from your girlfriend, Monica.
Yay.
Would you like to read it? I mean, you're a cool guy, right?
Yes.
I know that.
Does it say she's still with
you? Do you answer to the name Huggles?
Huggles for you. Looking forward to seeing you soon. Love, Monica. Beautiful.
Do you think you'll get married? It's a big question on everyone's lips.
No, we probably never get married, but me and her hopefully will be together for a while.
Oh, she's that's depressing. Girl. All right, good. More revelations after the break when I tie Gordon to the couch and probe him with our 11th famous Big Brother quick question.
Come on, everybody.
Take you through the show.
Well, I've probably had a lot of things that I've said and done, so don't know if you should mention all of them.
No, I'm not going to humiliate you. No, I'm here to comfort you.
Oh, excellent. Well, that'll work well.
Yeah, you're going to have a full-on week. You realise that, don't you? You're going to walk out into the street and everybody will recognise you.
Yeah, well, these two guys are here, so I'm sure they'll have a helping hand.
I'm not sure that they look that comforting, to tell you the truth. We'll bring them over onto the couch a little later. What was your hope when you went into the house?
Yeah, I just really wanted to have a good time and utilise the experience for what it was. And, yeah, you know, I had some level of expectations, but they were all sort of thrown out the door when we arrived. And I just sort of loved being there. And
tell me the truth. You looked pretty grumpy this last week.
Oh, I tell you, a few of those days I was going, I'm going nuts. But
How did you deal with going nuts?
Well, I mean, that was kind of good because I did want to, like, push myself into things that I hadn't normally done and deal with conditions that you're not used to. So, you know, as a personal growth thing, it was kind of cool, but...
So what drove you crazy?
Sort of non-interactivity, I guess. You know, people are pretty passive and just want to, like, chill out and, I don't know, do not a lot.
What are you going to do tonight?
Well, hopefully go out and have a few cold Stellas, but beyond that, I have no idea.
Look at you, plug, man. What other sponsors do you want?
Just my favourite products, you know.
And do you think that it was you with those people? Are they just not your kind of guys?
Oh, no, look, I didn't want to be there with people who were just like me, but I did think that after such a sort of rigorous selection process that people would have just been so much more amped up and have so much, you know, higher level of sort of charisma and stuff, but I guess people were just kind of don't know, falling back into their old routines and stuff, which is, you know.
What type of person would you say you are?
I have no idea.
Why do you think they kept nominating you? Are you annoying or just too lovable? What is it?
I guess I've got extremes, so people can easily love and hate me, which is kind of cool because I like being that person. I'd rather be loved and hated than sort of neutral and not remembered, so.
Do you think that you would have changed because of the intensity of this experience?
I think if I was there in the long term, it would have taken a lot longer to, say, rehabilitate back into the mainstream. But, 5 weeks is probably a good time.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. Can I just ask, with all of those cameras on, did you modify your behaviour in any way?
A little bit.
In what way?
I won't mention.
Sexually,
yeah.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Well, that's not what I saw. To say, if that was modified, I want to see the director's uncut version. Let's.
We're not going to show that, but are we?
We've shown it. We've shown it.
Fantastic.
No, the nation is proud.
I'm sure.
Yeah. Now let's bring your mates
over. Well,
you're
only humans.
Yeah.
Come on over here, quickly.
Oh.
Ivan, now, can you introduce your friends here for us?
This is Jason Martin and Anthony B.
How are you,
mate?
How's it?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Awesome.
All right, let's grab a seat. Now, snuggle up on the couch. Oh, what have you got there? I don't think he needs any extra balls. What have you got there? What are they?
Bouncy ball, probably
those
lights
balls.
Up. Yeah.
Are you sponsoring those as well? They're flash balls, are they?
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
All right, so how much did you miss him?
A lot.
Well, thanks for elaborating on that.
Jason's a big talker.
Would anyone else like to contribute to that question? Anthony, what about you?
Yeah, that was deep, Jason. We miss Flash a fair bit. He's brings a lot of colour and life, into our lives. So yeah, we've missed him.
Could I just say that the fact that you said these guys are live wires compared to the people in the house?
They're pretty chilled on video. I noticed when the camera came around the last time when they're doing interviews and stuff, everyone cameras. So, but I've kind of got used to it now.
Oh, really? Okay. Now, you know that we have the famous, world famous Big Brother questions. Are you ready for these? I want you to let me know if he's telling the truth or not.
Ooh.
All right. Number one, what did you miss the most?
I don't know.
Isn't this weird? I say it's 11 quick questions, but the answers are so slow. Do you want a hint?
Yes.
I don't know what you missed. What did he miss the most? Monica.
Yes, I would say that would have to be on the list of items.
I'd say it'd have to, too, for domestic harmony. Okay, number two. Who was your favourite person in the house?
I'd say Johnny.
Johnny?
Yeah.
That's not true, but he'll find out later.
Number three, who was your least favourite?
Shana.
Really? Number four, who had the most annoying habit and what was it?
No idea. No.
Maybe it was you.
Possibly.
Fiddling with that. Could you just concentrate and put that thing down?
It was probably me biting my nails, actually, yeah.
Really? All right.
Yeah.
Who was the person you could most fall in love with? And it can be a man or a woman.
Ooh. Gemma. Yeah, you could possibly fall in love with her if I wasn't otherwise taken or preoccupied with the girl.
But that's just hypothetically.
Yeah, that's hypothetically.
Doesn't even count.
Yeah,
Who is the funniest person?
Funniest person would have to be Ben.
Really? Isn't everybody says that? Who is the laziest person?
That would have to be Sara-Marie.
Sara, yes. You're certainly getting these answers correct, I have to tell you. Who is the cleanest person?
Cleanest person?
That would have to be Gemma, wouldn't it?
Well, she puts her makeup on 10 times a day, but I'm not sure if that's cleanliness or paranoia.
Yes, compulsive obsession. You're right. All right, what's your greatest regret from your time in the house?
None.
None? I might come back to that question.
Okay,
who will be out next week?
Ooh, well, I was wrong this week, so...
Who did you think would be out this week?
I really thought Lisa would be out. Just... Yeah. But,
all right, who do you think will win?
Oh. Blair.
Why do you think Blair's going to win?
He's probably young and he's got the right sort of balance and whatever.
Did you ever think you'd win?
No.
You didn't?
No, not a chance.
All right, let's have a look at your legacy item, which you have brought from the house.
Yes.
We're going to auction it for charity.
Lovely.
Who is your chosen charity?
Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Great. Okay. Make-A-Wish Foundation. Now, why is this so important to you? Did you have a history with it before you went into the house?
I had a history with a similar one that had a explosion in the house, but I've got this big large house and stuff, so we've got heaps of soft toys hanging to fill up the space and stuff, so this is an identical killer whale.
Fantastic. If you would like to make a bid on this fabulous item, then you can find out the details of the auction on bigbrother.com.au. Now, can I just ask you, what do you think is in store for you now?
No idea at all.
Do you think you'll go back to life as it was?
No, I'll go on holiday.
Will you?
Yeah.
Where will you go? Can we come too?
Yeah, Thailand, Cambodia probably.
Oh, chill really?
Yeah.
Chill out in Cambodia. Good idea. We've got two presents here for you.
Lovely.
We've got this Sony 8 digital handycam.
Which is exactly what I always wanted.
Well, isn't that perfect? This is all your Christmases. And here, something that every house needs, a Sony PlayStation 2.
Beautiful.
All right, perfect. Now, we have Leah Haywood here. You are going to dance. All right. All of you are going to dance. So get up onto the dance floor. We've got a show to finish. Come on. Now, just when you thought it was all over, it actually hasn't even begun, because the next 7 days will be the most radical ride in the Big Brother house. This week, the life of every single housemate will be turned upside down. It's a surprise, it is top secret, but this week, everything changes. Big Brother has an extraordinary surprise in store, and on Friday night, there will be a special edition of Big Brother Live. What will happen? What does it all mean? How crazy can things get? Stay watching and strap in for the ride. Now, to play us out, we have Leah Haywood singing Take 'Em Back What's Mine. And remember, Big Brother is watching.
Don't I want back in your game?